Good evening, everyone. My name is Jianan Cheng, and I am the Director of Orchestral Activities at Rowan University. I want to welcome all of you for coming to our concert. I also want to welcome all the friends who are watching in the friendly, sensory-friendly watch party right now. Welcome, all of you. Tonight, we're really excited to be joined by a Metachian High School Chamber Orchestra, who was the winner of our Spring Festival last year. About a few years ago, we started our Rowan String Festival, which is a two-day event. We invite 10 high school or middle school string ensembles to come here, actually perform in this concert hall, and they also receive feedback and clinics from Rowan faculty. And I have to say, our Spring Festival has gotten really competitive, especially in like the last couple of years. There are many schools from North Jersey and Central New Jersey with very strong spring programs. They bring their string ensembles here and they perform and compete here. And the slots are always filled immediately after we open the registration. And there's a wait list. There's a wait list right now for this year. So last year, Metachian High School Chamber Orchestra came to our Spring Festival, and they had a stunning performance. They were so prepared, and everybody was really, really impressed. And their director, Chris McEwen, did a fantastic job leading them. You can always tell when a director is doing a great job, when you see that there's a lot of enthusiasm from their students. So tonight we are really honored to have them here open our concert, and actually in the second half, some of them will be joining us and play side by side with our students in the Shostakovich. So without further ado, please welcome to the stage Metachian High School Chamber Orchestra and their director, Christopher McEwen.
Thank you.
department at Rowan University, we have a lot of talented students, and even though we have an annual concerto competition, but we can only pick one winner each year for one ensemble. And it always pains me when I see all these other talented students who probably also deserve to play a concerto. So for that reason, I try to program some concertos from year to year, especially for like a specific instrument, in a way to provide more opportunities for these students to perform concertos. So in the past 3 years, we have done a clarinet concerto, a cello concerto, and this year is the viola concerto. So tonight's soloist will be Juan Villanueva. He is currently a second year student at Rowan as a violin performance major. And he actually just took on viola and started taking lessons from last semester. It's amazing to see how quickly that he progressed. And also it's amazing just to see how his musicianship comes through on this new instrument as well. And this concerto tonight will be conducted by Ian Pang, a first year master's student in orchestral conducting at Rowan. Ian is from Hong Kong, and he actually just received his clarinet performance degree from the Venice School of Music. So tonight will be his Rowan conducting debut. Please enjoy Brooks' Romance for Viola with Juan Villanueva and Ian Pang. Welcome back, everyone. So in this half of the concert, we are going to perform Shostakovich Symphony No. 5, movements 1, 2, and 4. Let me just say a few words about Shostakovich and his music. Even though when it comes to Shostakovich, it's never easy to just say a few words. He was really a fascinating composer, and this symphony just has so much depth and so many layers of meanings. What led to the composition of the symphony was that he wrote a satire opera called Lady Macbeth of the Mtsensk district. It's a masterpiece, but it's a violent piece, and the music is really dissonant, and there are many not very nice things happening in the opera, like murder and adultery, and that was not okay. That was a problem because of the Soviet Union Communist Party. It didn't fit with their values. According to them, everything was supposed to be about happiness, celebration, and victory. And they were kind of controlling the intellectuals and the artists with what they were able to express. And they were actually secretly executing people for that reason. They believed they had the opposing voice to the party. So actually many of Shostakovich's friends and peers disappeared. They were executed. So after that opera, Shostakovich received a very serious warning, aka a death threat from the authority. And his opera was getting canceled, and the subsequent Symphony No. 4 was forced to withdraw as well. So his life was really dependent on this next piece he would write. He would either have to conform, or he might be the next one to disappear. So he wrote the Symphony No. 5. And he kind of gave them what they wanted. He wrote a very triumphant ending, and the finale sounds like a military march, the music is not as dissonant for Shostakovich. And the second movement, for example, it's kind of like a dance music, happier, and it's like a waltz. So even though his life was saved because of that symphony, he still put these little hidden things or ironies in this piece. They're not that obvious because he probably did and did not hope that anybody would discover them. But that's what's really fascinating about this piece, that there are so many layers of things just, you know, beyond the surface. For example, this entire symphony, even though the ending is really triumphant, but if you listen to the symphony, really, the entire piece just has something really dark and suppressed, kind of looming over this entire piece. The first movement, for example, the first theme is already very dark. It's right at the beginning when you hear in the strings, they play this canon of four sets of this two-note motive. That's the first theme. And the second theme is actually something comforting. It's like the light and the hope of that movement. But in the recapitulation, when the first theme comes back, instead of just hearing that first theme, like in many other sonata form movements, we now hear both the first theme and the second theme together at the same time. But now the second theme is not comforting at all. It's played in the brass and it's screaming. It's been savage. Some scholars actually call this moment the rape of the second theme. So it's a really chaotic moment. And another example is in the second movement. In the middle section, you will hear this really beautiful and light melody, first played by the solo violin, and then on the solo flute. It's like a ballerina dancing. It's just pure, beautiful, and innocent. And you hear this melody kind of a couple of times, but each time it's interrupted and suppressed by a more forceful or demanding voice. And then, at the end of this movement, when the oboe plays this theme again, just a few things got turned around. A few notes were changed, and now also the articulations were reversed. So now it sounds almost a little evil. So in my opinion, it almost feels like the innocent has been killed in that moment. It's like now we have the evil twin sister of that same theme or something. So there are so many little things. That's really what's fascinating about this piece. Like I said, I could go on and go on for Shostakovich. So welcome once again. Thank you for coming to our concert. Please enjoy Shostakovich's Symphony No. 5, and have a great rest of your evening.
Thank you.